Hello, hello. Welcome back to our first playthrough of Endless Ocean. I am so excited. I cannot wait. We've been chatting about this for what feels like about a week now, maybe a little longer. Let's just dive right in. Well, good day there. Welcome to Manoa Lai, pride and joy of the Pelagio Commonwealth. Now, customs need your information, so let's start with your name and gender. I'm doing this with a controller, so it's a little difficult. There we go. Is this okay? Yes. Jeez. Yes. Oi, that's a splendid name, that is. But I'm not sure we got your picture right, so let me ask you a few more questions. It gets fair hot down here. What kind of tan are you hoping for? Fair. Is this okay? Yes. I could have guessed it. And now let's check your hairstyle. How would you like it? Mild or wild? Let's go wild. Is this okay? Sure. And now let's check your hairstyle. How would you like it, black or brown? Brown. There we go. That's fine, I suppose. Crikey, I may have to give that one a go myself. Sorry, mate. This one tends to be a ramble a touch. Right, so we're all square then? Yeah, that's okay. Let's wrap up your immigration procedure. Manoa Lai offers one of the many of the South Pacific's greatest diving locations. Take your time and explore to your heart's content. I just know you're gonna love Manoa Lai. Have a great time, mate. Yay, no data, let's start. Yes. Manoa Lai Sea. The western sea off Manoa Lai Island abounds with unspoiled beauty and natural resources. I'm gonna move my mouse. Let's see what they've got. So excited! Test, test. Hello, can you hear me? I'm your partner. My name's Catherine Sunday, but you can call me Cat. I'm here to give you advice and to help whatever you need. Manoa Lai is an awesome place and there's tons to learn. But first, we've got to get you up to speed. So let's go. Okay, first things first, let's take care of the basics. I'm going to run you through directional controls. Yeah, so let's have a turn. Let's have a turn to the north. Use the compass in the top left corner to get your bearings. Changing direction. Point the Wiimote at the screen and change direction accordingly. Try to aim north, the left side of your screen. And bingo, looking good. Now try turning east. Hopefully the volume's not too loud. Let's turn east. Oops. Hey, nice! Did you turn around a lot? Because you're a pro! Ha ha ha! I think you're ready for the next step. Let's try swimming. You're going to need to kick your fins. I want you to swim straight ahead and to the east. Okay, aim the aim the remote at the screen and press B to swim in the direction you are pointing. Oh, hey, let me remind you where B is. It's not in the place where it's supposed to be, but thanks. Thanks anyway. Oh, aim down. Cool. Ooh, I'm getting it. Ooh, look at the manta, the hippo tangs, the butterfly fish. Look at them all, they're so pretty. The lagoon. This is the lagoon. It's a small saltwater lake located on the west side of Manoa Lai Island. This is a good little place for viewing tropical fish. Okay, so head east until you reach the center area. Okay, oops. Head east. Look at the little hippo tangs. Butterfly fish. Great, that's a good one right there. Let's see, what else? Oh, I almost forgot about the auto swim function. It's the way to go when you're covering long distances. But only the most skilled divers can even attempt this. Huh. Can you do it? Awesome. Can you show me? Press the minus button to swim forward automatically, and press any button to stop. Sweet. Oh, there's blue tangs. Powder blues. Wow, what's up, dive pro? That's a great technique for getting around without any hassle. Or for being lazy, I guess. Anyway, you can look pretty comfortable down there. I think it's time to have you come back to the boat. Go ahead and make your way back to the Gambiano. Return to boat. Open the tool menu by pressing left or right on the D-pad and then selecting return to boat to finish diving. Let's choose return to boat. Yes. The Gambiano, your small but sturdy vessel. Oh, hi, friend. Back already, huh? Did you have fun down there?
Of course.
So far. It gets kind of lonely out here. It's nice to have company. So yeah, my job is basically to protect the ocean and all its creatures. And that's where you come in. I can't do my job without a top diver. What? What do you do? That's the easy part. Mostly you just hang out and dive when you feel like it. Although we get specific requests from the Marianas Foundation sometimes. They provide our funding, so you should probably oblige them, but you don't have to. You know, pretty laid back, huh? I think I'd go crazy if I had to work in an office. Same. Yeah. Oh, sounds like we have a new mail. Wonder what we got. Why don't you go into the cabin and check the email? Interesting, okay. Moving and interacting. Point the location and hold B to walk with that direction. You can interact with certain locations by pressing A. Alright. This is our cabin. It's full of gear and maps and all of that jazz. It's basically our nerve center. You'll need all of this stuff eventually, but right now you can only use the mobile device, dive lock, and lock. Don't worry, the other stuff will be available soon. Currently you have to read mail, advance the time, and save options. Examine an item with A. Okay, let's see. The save option? as I'm sure it, you know, saves our progress. You can save your log progress here. Sure, save our progress. Yes, continue. Read mail. You can receive mail on your mobile device. This is useful for gaining new information or fielding requests. Be sure to check it frequently. Alrighty. Greetings from Alfred Thorman. Good day, my name is Alfred Thorman, and I am the head of the Pelagio branch of the Marianas Foundation. As you probably know, we are your chief financial backer. Is it not auto? You are familiar with the Coral Forest, yes? Well, we would like you to perform a brief topographical inspection there. Simply dive to the Coral Forest and wait for instructions from Catherine. There is no hurry on this. Please take your time. Okay. The Coral Forest is just west of here. Here's a map to help you complete your topographical surveys. You can press 1 to view the map. Okay. You can now use the map. Yay! People say it's gorgeous. What? Me? No, I've never been there. Why not? Oh, you know, I'm pretty busy and have stuff to do, and I can't swim. Look, it's just one of those things. I don't really want to talk about it. All right, your business. Open the tool menu. Okay. Dive. Yes, of course. Let's go for a dive. Embrace of Manoa Lai, Endless Ocean. Down we go. Such a pretty, like, cutscene. Not really a cutscene, but, like a loading screen. Hey, do you know a lot about fish? Well, I do. Ironically, right? They're kind of my specialty. So let me help you out. I can be your fish whisperer. Sorry, lame joke. Anyway, fish can take center stage in the ocean. Let me teach you how to examine a fish. Point at an animal in the water and press A to focus on it. Okay. Let's point at... Ooh, it's not really easy with the D-pad. I got it. But I thought... this is very awkward with the controller. Come here now. Come here. Okay, I pressed A. Are we focusing on it? I don't think so. Let's find a different fish. Maybe one a wee bit larger. There we go. Okay, you're focused on an animal now. This is good. When this happens, you'll automatically follow the animal in focus. Next, you should view information on the critter. Press the bar on the lower portion of the screen to view information about the targeted creature. Okay. Once you become more familiar with this animal, you will learn more about it. Okay. Yeah, we don't know much about this guy yet, but that's where you come in. If you become more familiar with an animal, you'll learn more about it. We have special permission to work with animals. It's pretty big honor here, so treat them well. Try interacting with a fish. You can interact with creatures while they are in focus. Use the Wii remote to gently touch or pet them. Cool. Like this. You pet them like this. Can you touch with A, pet, and shake the Wii remote. While focused on an animal, hold A and shake the Wii remote. Point at a target and touch to press A. Okay, well, I thought that's what I was doing. Oh, I see. That's it. Aw, look, it likes you. You're a natural. In addition to interacting directly with animals, you can also use food to get their attention. Select food from the tool menu and try using it. Food, okay. Oh, I thought we were supposed to... Manta ray, okay. Food. If you're kind and gentle to underwater creatures, you can become very familiar with them. You may not even know what they're called in the beginning, but you'll learn tons of interesting things as you become more familiar with them. Check them often, okay? I can see what you know your way around. What? How did I know? I can put a small video camera on your tank that lets me see everything. It's just for safety, silly. I'm not going to follow you around or anything. Anyway, the coral forest is west of here. I marked it on the map and you can check it out with your map. Sweet. Well, let's go. Just west, which is this way. Oh, that was fun. Little dive trick, I see. Wonder if I could do it again. Whee! Ah, that was fun. Wonder if we can become more familiar with this one. The... Oh, what is that? Looks like a parrotfish, I think. Can I interact with it? Maybe? I wonder if you could only interact with the bigger fish. That'd be kind of sad. Definitely a missed opportunity, but I feel like for the age of this game, there probably was limited amount of data that they could put onto it, so... All is forgiven. Ooh, a Napoleon fish. Some more angel fish. The coral forest. This is the coral forest. It's just like the name says. The coral grows here like a majestic underwater forest. Huh? Ooh, look at it. Zoom in, it's absolutely zoom in. Oh, that must be a dolphin that got separated from its pod. Or else he was playing a prank on us. I've never had a dolphin make fun of me like that before. That was great! Anyway, we're done researching the terrain. Nice job. I've got all the data I need. You can just dive at your leisure now. Come back to the Gambiano when you're tired. Sweet. Can I inspect you? I just want to look. Pretty sure this is a parrotfish. Maybe. I would love to inspect you. It looks like I can. Maybe I'm just not pushing the right button. There we are. Can we pet it? Pet. Let's try feed. Wait, let me pet you. Okay. I just want two pets. See what we can see. Oh, here's some tangs. Look like a Sail fin tangs. Pretty. If I could get to them. Butterflies? I think. There we are. Got it. Can I feed it, I suppose? Nom nom? No? Pretty sure this is a yellow sailfin tang, but who's to know? Who's to know? Forgot how to pet it already. There we go. Yay, yellow tang, I was right. Sweet. That's so funny. Yay! Let's see if we got updated information. Roughly 8 inches, yellow tangs have narrow elliptical bodies with large dorsal fins and anal fins, protruding mouths and a very cheery yellow color. They can be found year-round in the Minoalae. Very cool. Maybe I can go back and pet the parrotfish. See if we can get more information on it. Pet, pet, pet. Yeah, bicolor parrotfish. I was right. 1 point for me. Okay, I already fed you, so let's see what your entry has to say. Roughly 2 feet, these fish have narrow, spindle-shaped bodies with round heads. They are mostly blue with hints of green, I believe. With hints of peach on the edges of the fins. They can be seen all year round in the lagoon. So I'm getting the feeling that we're going to see seasonal fish too, which is pretty neat. Ooh, what are these? I'm curious, and they're shoaling. This is neat. A shoal of, what are you? What are you? Let me pet. Let me pet. Pyramid of butterfly fish. Length is roughly 6 inches. These colorful fish have narrow elliptical bodies and conical mouths. They are colored in a variety of browns, yellow, and whites. They can be seen in Minoalae all year round. So we're getting the year-round fish. Let's see if I can get this butterfly. Please, you, specifically you. No, not the pyramid. Let's see if I can find one that's on its own. I know this is a hippo tang or a regal blue tang. Yeah, blue tang. Let's give it some food. Maybe it'll become our friend. Looks like the ones in the back are a little tasty and hungry too. Yep, they're all a little hungry. See what else we can find. Here's some powder blue tangs. They look like exactly like powder blue tangs. A school of them, at least. Yeah, powder blue tang. Look at me. Aren't we proud of me? Yay! I see a Napoleon fish back there, too. Actually, I want to see if I can feed them, because there's a bunch of them. Oh, they're too far away. Okay, well. A Napoleon. Oh, I guess I was wrong. This is a humphead wrasse. Thank you. Can we feed you? Neat. Let's see what we can find out. They're about 7 feet long. Ooh, those are whoppers. These slow, curious fish have a large elliptical bodies with a bump-like protrusion on the head. They're usually a striking blue and green color. They are very pretty and very vibrant in real life as well, which is pretty. They're really neat to see. Just the sheer size of them, you know? Okay, let's see what else. I think this is a typical, like, angel fish? Angelfish? Emperor angel. I think I'm going to give that a go. That is my guess. I think this is an adult emperor angel. Because juveniles look strikingly different. Or maybe it's a queen angelfish. It's either an emperor or a queen. Yeah, emperor. I'm on a streak here. That's pretty awesome. Proud of myself with my identification skills. Let's feed this one too. Nom. Nom nom. They're all hungry. Nom nom nom. Oh, they're all excited and want to be friends. Yes. So happy. What else can we find? See, we've got some little butterflies right here. Ooh, other way. We can get their attention. Maybe? See if we can unlock our encyclopedia. More on our encyclopedia. Here we are. Long-nose butterfly fish. In aquarium settings, these fish, while they are beautiful, they're incredibly hard to keep because they are very particular about what they eat. And if you're not feeding them enough live food that are small enough, so like mysis, or like small mysis, but they prefer brine shrimp. They usually won't eat and end up perishing because they just starve themselves to death, which is kind of sad. But if you're able to get them meat and are willing to feed them brine shrimp, they usually will thrive and they become very, very beautiful fish. It's kind of cute to watch them eat it too because their mouths are so tiny. So tiny, so tiny. Okay, have we seen most of what we came to see? I feel like there should be something more, but we just started, so we can't have everything at the beginning of the game, right? I'm glad there's no meter, like a tank meter. So you can kind of stay down here as long as you like. I wonder if in the new one you'll have to, you'll have to watch, like, some meter or something like that. Thank you. Ooh, what is this? It's a sailfin tame. I think it's a Desjardini tame. If I'm right, I'm gonna be elated. I actually have one of these in my home tanks, but they look a little bit different from this. Why can't I interact with you? Sounds very ominous, but I'm going to guess this is a sailfin tame. Yep. Specifically a Desjardini. I know there's a few different ones, but Desjardinis are a little bit more they're typically yellow and black. So I could be wrong on this one. But it is a sailfin, so I got that much right. They're very skittish creatures. I see a triggerfish right here in the background. Those are really neat fish. Go check them out. They are carnivores. I remember when I was working in an aquatic store, we would feed them clams on the half shell and they would go nuts. Yeah. It's the clown triggerfish. Hello, friend. Clown triggerfish! Another one. Yes, I'm doing great today. I'm certain there's going to be some that I don't know, but I will take joy and pride in the ones that I do. Yeah, they're really pretty, but they are carnivorous fish. They're a little bit aggressive, so if you ever keep them in a species-dominant tank, so have more triggerfish, or just don't put them with fish that are docile, because they'll bully them. Hands down. There's something else over here. Yeah. I think this is an angel? I'm not too sure. Moorish idol. Oh. Can we pet you, friend? No. No pets. It's so small. Okay, fair. Let's go this way. There's another shoal of blue tangs. Outer blue tangs. Some sail fins, more triggerfish. How neat. Let's check out our map. Oh, we've discovered a new area, it seems. Blue holes, and this is coral forest. This is really pretty. And for a Wii game, like this, I was expecting not anything bad, but as far as the graphics and detail, like even seeing the light kind of shine through from the surface is a nice little touch, you know? Like, I don't know what I was expecting, but it wasn't this, and I'm pleasantly surprised. Let's return to the boat. Pleasantly surprised. I really like it so far. The Manoa Lai Sea. Oh, penguin! I feel like this is a little tropical for a penguin. Could be wrong, but... Hey, look! Let me put my mouse over here. What a cutie, huh? I think he came to say hi. I think I'm concerned for the penguin. This little fellow is an African penguin. They're native to southern coasts of Africa. But there are a few that hang out here around Manoa Lai, too. You can interact with animals on your boat by pointing and pressing A. There's going to be more animals on our boat? Hello, little friend. You can interact with animals to increase their familiarity. You can pet them, and I'm assuming we can feed them too, like you can fish. Can we? Oh, we can't feed you yet, friend. Sorry, little pengu. Height is roughly 2 feet. These simple birds have spindle-shaped bodies and long feathers. Their coloring is mostly black and white, but with a more complicated diet, but with a more complicated pattern than seen on other penguins around the world. The eyes around the eyes are pink because of a small flap of exposed skin. They may appear on your boat from time to time. Well, they are welcome because they're so stinking adorable. You can come on my boat any day, friend. Any day, any day. Always trying to fly. It's like he's saying, hold on. He's saying, I like you. I'm going to come back with all of my friends. Oh boy. What? Oh, come on. Don't stare at me like that. Yes, I know what the animals are saying. I've been studying marine biology my whole life. All it takes is a lot of careful observation and experience. Just look at their faces and then Aww. Oh, I don't know. I guess it's as much of an intuition than anything else. So, yeah, let's talk about something else. Did I tell you I'm writing a marine biology encyclopedia? I thought maybe you'd like to help out with it. The more you can learn, the better the encyclopedia will be. So, try to learn a lot of new stuff, okay? You'll need to get familiar with the marine life and fill the encyclopedia. It's waiting in the cabin, so take a look when you feel like it. Ooh, okay. Let's go check out and see if anything that we've... like the fish that we encountered are in the encyclopedia. Oh geez, I forgot something else. I think the penguin distracted me. That was some nice work you did down there. There's a lot of ocean to cover outside the lagoon, right? Look, it's okay. I can tell that you're one of those types with, ambition. So you're going to get tired of the lagoon before long. Don't worry. You can take the Gambiano if you want. Just sail it to a new area and start diving from that point. I made an extra key for you. Aw, that's nice of her. You can now use the steering wheel. Woohoo! I'm gonna go take a nap, so... oh, wait, I almost forgot. About that key I gave you? It can also open the Nintendo Wi-Fi connection gate on the bow of the boat. Unfortunately, not for us, because we are playing this game a lot late. You can use that to visit a friend or let them visit you. If you make friends, say hi to for me, okay? Dang. This would have been really fun to play together back in the day. You have new mail. Let's go check the mail. Read mail. What happened in the cabin? There we go. A little Pingu Chen just walking around being all cute. Encyclopedia. Let's see what mail has to say. Oh, there's a lot of mail. Following up. This is Alfred Thormagen. I take it the things went well with your survey off the of the coral forest. Good job. There are many unexplored areas in the Manoa Lai Sea, so these kinds of surveys help considerably. In fact, still getting used to the controls. In fact, I wanted to mention a spot to the south known as the Blue Holes. Rare items have been known to drift into that area, so if you have time, you might want to take a look. Until next time, Alfred Thormagen. Thanks, Alfred. This newsletter provides information on beautiful diving locations around Manoa Lai. The lagoon, the true lagoon. This shallow pool off the west coast of Manoa Lai joins the sea via a narrow channel. Though the lagoons are often enclosed behind barrier reefs, this one is actually behind a sandbar. Shake your dive thing. You'll find a wide variety of plant and marine life in this colorful lagoon. It's like diving in your very own aquatic disco. Interesting. Coral forest. Okay. I think it's just giving us more info about it. This newsletter provides information on the beautiful dive locations around Manoa Lai. The Blue Holes, which we haven't got to yet. Holy cow! What a great pun. So many... a rock formation with so many small caves, divers are treated to the views of none other than the beams of light that pour in from the openings ahead. Overhead. At one time, this formation was above ground, but rising oceans and erosion gradually created the formation we enjoy today. Ebb and flows. Yeah, it seems like just a... I don't really care about that. I want to dive. Traveling in the Gambiano. Here you can sail to the Gambiano to any location on the map. Once you arrive, you can you can dive from that spot. Cool. It's the coral forest. Can't go to blue holes yet? I think it's because we haven't dove there. No. Don't want to move the boat. Actually, let's move the boat to coral forest and then see if we can get to the blue hole. That's not what I wanted. Wrong button. All right, let's dive. See what we can find. Let's check the map. So we haven't been to Blue Hole yet. We can go this way and extend our map, it looks like. And see what we can discover this way. Right, some more butterfly fish, long-nosed butterflies. Some blue tangs, blue hippos. Oops. Oh, are we blocked? Yeah, we can't go this way. Can we? Yeah, no. Too shallow, I guess. I wonder if this is how we get to the new location. I bet it is. Powder blue tangs. Blue holes, yeah. So we should be able to dive here or move the boat here soon. Hey, listen, I just remembered something. There's supposed to be some kind of precious object here. At least that's what Thorman said in his email. Why don't we try looking for it? There's something in there. Ooh. Let's get closer and check it out. Get near the seafloor wall or the other object and press plus to enter the zoom mode. You can then examine the area in more detail. Hey, look at that. This is how you find small fish or items that you might not otherwise see. Try interacting with what's here. I don't know. What's here? I don't think there's anything we can pet or feed. Interesting. Check out some of the table coral. That's the big flat stuff, thanks. I think that's the only one, but I didn't see. Ah. Wait. What are you? Oh! How cute. Oh, I know what these are. These are firefish. Yes, these are firefish. Let's feed them. Yeah, firefish. I've kept one of these. Elegant firefish. They are quite pretty. Let me pet you. Can I pet you? They're just so small. Probably not. They're tiny. About 3 inches. These fish have long, skinny bodies and with a highly extended dorsal fin. Their color changes from purple to that of... purple from the tip of the head to white at the midsection and back, and dark purple at the tail. They can be seen year-round. Cool. They're quite pretty. They're very vibrant in person. But they like to hide, so if you ever discover one or really want to like keep one in an aquarium, just know that they're going to hide very often. So you may not see them if you have a lot of rock work. Hey, Acromis. I believe that's a Chromis. Can I interact with you? Maybe we can interact with it. Here we are. We cannot pet the Chromis. Can we feed the Chromis? Is the Chromis even hungry? Does not look like it. Oops. So either a blue or a green Chromis. Does not seem to like being petted. Friend! Okay, bye. It's a little difficult. Well, let's loop back. There we go. Oh. Gold medal champion. What are you, though? More interesting enough, what are you? Here, let me pet you. Ugh. To grab and acquire an object, point at it and press B while holding down A. I just want the fish. I don't care about the metal. We don't... press down B while holding A. Select subject B. Got the dolphin metal. Okay. But I want the fish. Looks like you found a rare object. Hey, friend. Hey, it's that dolphin again. You remember that prankster dolphin from the coral forest? Sure do. Look at him. He's just so curious about you. Why don't you try interacting with him? Come on, take a chance. Cute. Aw, look. This is awesome. And he said, no thanks, see you later, bye. See you later. He vanished. I think you scared him away. He's heading towards the lagoon. Why don't you head back to the Gambiano? Then we can follow him. I mean, you know if you want. So we're to chase the poor thing. I think we could just go to the boat from here, yeah. Your small boat is a sturdy vessel. The Gambiano means seagull in Italian. Ooh, we uncovered more of the map. Nice. If you find stuff in the ocean, I'll put it in your footlocker. Thanks. Why don't we find everything in one convenient place? If we learn anything about items, you can check that out too. We donate most finds to the local museum, and they love us there. This is where you can store your items. Thanks. We get it. You have new mail. Let me go see my Pingu friend. Where is he? Oh, there's... Oh my god, there's more. There's an emperor penguin. Call him Pinguino. What are you doing here, friend? On my boat. Southern rockhopper penguin. Oh, it is not an emperor. These birds have spindle-shaped bodies and yellow decorative feathers that assemble in fluffy eyebrows. They are black in the head, on the head and back, and the white on the belly. Southern rockhopper penguins sometimes appear on your boat. Cool. So I take it this doesn't happen often, so we'll have to check out all of our little penguins. These look like the same species, though, as the other. Oh, guess not. Adelie penguin. An angular look, okay. African pingu friend. Who are you? All of the penguins coming to visit us today. The Gentoo penguin. Alright, let's go check the mail. And then I think we're nearing on our first hour of the game. That's pretty exciting. Let's read the mail. Diving guide, oops, request. Someone wants us to guide them. It's from the Marianas Foundation request officer, Aubrey Thorman, excuse me. Hi there, my name is Aubrey Thorman. I handle all the requests for the diving guides in the Manoa Lai region. Anyway, I have a request for you to act as a diving guide. That the client's name is Will Gain, and he is a pretty valued client, so treat him really nice, okay? He wants to dive in the coral forest. There's no fixed date, but could you please let us know when you have time, okay? Thanks. Reply. Can you reply? Yeah, let's reply so we can actually... I think he said he wanted to dive in the coral forest. Yeah, the coral forest. Guide at this point? Yes. That's where the guy said he wanted to go. So we're going. Right, Triton? Oh, here he comes. In his jet ski. Hi there. Thanks for being my guide. My name is Will Gain. Since we're in Manoa Lai, I'd love to see the humphead wrasse. Okay, easy enough. It's been a while since I've gone diving, and I'm counting on your guidance. I've gone as deep as 60 feet, but I don't really want to go any deeper. Understood. Down we go. Embrace of Manoa Lai, endless ocean. If you find a creature you want to show a client, focus on it to get the client's attention. Okie dokie. If you find a creature requested by a client, show it off. It will make them very happy. Easy enough, we just need to find a wrasse. Humphead wrasse, and they're pretty hard. Where is it? Where is? Oh, he's about to get upset. A humphead rat? I didn't forget, bro. I didn't forget. Clearly, our friend doesn't want to be seen, okay? Okay, we're back in the forest. I found it! Wow. Should not have been that hard, but we found him. I found it! Even the music got more cheery. Jeez. You found it! Yes, after much complaint, I found your friend. Let's feed the little guy. I wonder if that actually boosted our knowledge of it. Doesn't look like it. Well, there he is. I can't wait to tell my friends about this. Yeah, about being a pain in the ass and complaining every 5 minutes. Let's get you out of here. Return to boat. Can't please everybody. Except when you try to. Neat. This place looks huge. We've only experienced a small portion of it. That was amazing! I can't believe you're so new at this! Listen, I want to give you something as a thank you. You received a small pen? Great. It's exactly what I wanted. No. This is a prototype that's being developed at my company. It uses light-emitting particles to stimulate hydrogen molecules so that they express, well, never mind. It's basically just a pen that works underwater. We call it a water pen. Name needs a little work, huh? Yeah, like a lot of work. Anyway, you can use it to mark the locations or write your notes to friends. The only limit is your imagination. Did that sound too cheesy? Well, I have to get going. I hope you can show me around again sometime soon. Thanks, guy, for the pen. Just gonna scoot off in your, jet ski. You have new mail. Oh, the sun is going down. You can't go night diving. Not yet, anyway. We don't have the proper equipment. Why don't you call it a day? You can catch some Z's in the cabin if you want. Well, I think this is the best place to start, to stop, to get in the cabin, thank you, to stop our adventure, and play again another day. There's new mail with an attachment. Huh. Find gear that suits your own style. You got the beclaimed sea suit. How do I change my suit? Oh, gear. Cool. Ooh, I like that one. Looks like we don't have other gear. Oops. Neat. Oops, I forgot to save. Swimmy, swimmy. Would you like to continue? No. So this will be the end of our first playthrough, or not playthrough, but first episode of Endless Ocean. It's pretty nice. I've liked it so far. And I can't wait to experience more of it with you. So if you enjoy it, if you think it's fun so far, let me know in the comments what you think.